How do you get the candle up there?
Oh, we can sit back here.
Just there.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
found in the temple area those who had sold oxen, sheep, and doves, as well as the money changers seated there. He made a whip out of the cords and drove them out, all out of the temple area, with the sheep and the oxen, and spilled the coins of the money changers and overturned their tables. And to those who sold doves, he said, "Take these out of here and stop making my father's house a marketplace."
So as we go from Holy Temple, the Holy Temple today, realize that we are the temple of the Holy Spirit. And that as we step through so many other buildings that have been before, that our faith is renewed, that we are being transformed out of this building, so that when we go home, hopefully we can try a little more. Be more attentive, be alive ever deeper in our faith, so that in a world that is so often just pulled in so many different directions, that does not have, as we heard in our second reading, the only foundation, Jesus Christ. You know, that they'll come to experience through us in some way an invitation to follow. To follow Christ. There was the invitation that Benedict offered, the invitation St. Francis offered, the invitation when we celebrate Mass tomorrow, the tomb of St. John Paul II, that he offered. So the only reason we're here is because of them, for the people who passed on the faith to us. So let us especially remember those in our own lives who have helped us.
Very well shined. Have you seen a lot of barbarians yesterday, right? Yes. You know, we are surrounded by barbarians all the time. He's barbarian too. Also, if it's called the Julius, huh? Julius, you are barbarian. Look, the barbarian. Here we have. Those walls are 17th century old, but for the modern traffic, the city hall had to open those extra archives, because otherwise the walls got only 14 gates. Too narrow for the capital of Italy, as Rome is.